I'm often being asked if and how you can do automated roasts on the Aillio Bullet. And in fact, this is very well possible. It's working great and it's super consistent. And the function for that in RoasTime is called recipes. In the Aillio Bullet Masterclass, I did a section where we deep dive into recipes, where I explain everything, and then where we do a step-by-step setup of recipes that we then use on the Aillio Bullet. By the way, if the Aillio Bullet Masterclass is of interest to you, this is an online course on this machine where we talk in more than 4.5 hours about everything related to the Aillio Bullet, all its functions, how it's working, but we will also be talking about the roasting in general and then always do a direct connection related to the Aillio Bullet on how to do the right settings to get the best out of this machine. If this is of interest to you, then have a look at the masterclass where you find the link right here or in the description. But now let's start with the topic, which is recipes on the Aillio Bullet. So I have this roast now saved. So what I can do now, besides of editing, overlay and playback, is I can create a recipe of this profile. Recipe means that I don't always copy a roast directly. I can then also change a recipe. So for example, change the power settings. I can also create a recipe completely from the scratch. I can copy a recipe that I found on the Roast World from another roaster. So with recipes, I just have more flexibilities to create the roast, but then when I have created a recipe, it will be actually about the same as playback. It will just automatically do all the settings that I have defined. And to show you how I can create a recipe from a roast, I can now click on this button and then I have the possibility to choose a recipe based on the IBTS sensor, on the bean sensor, or on the time. The IBTS is just the best reference for a playback roast, actually, because it's the most precise sensor. And I can choose all of these settings that I've done, add them to the recipe, and then I have here my recipe. And I'm first going to give it a name. So I say recipe Tutorial English, and I've got the Mala 500 gram. He knows it because he took it from the other roast. And when I go from top down, I can see here that I have a preheat temperature of 280 degrees in this recipe, which I could of course change if I want to. So I can choose any other preheat temperature as well, but let's take the same again. And then this power setting, fan setting, drum settings are the first settings that will happen when I have reached preheat and when I started the roast. So that start of the roast will be with power 10, which is of course, as always, something that I can then change in the settings. So I can save this. And then I have temperature steps. I have deactivated the time in my roast. Nevertheless, roast time shows me here a minimum time, but it's always minimum 5 seconds, but that doesn't really help me a lot. I take it away and I have now a bit an easier view, and I can just see that when the roast has reached 79.3 degrees on the IBTS, it will change the fan from the previous setting 5 to setting 4. I can do any other setting as well. I can do 3, I can do 5, whatever I like. So I can adapt these steps a little bit. Say, let's say at 80 degrees, I do this setting. I can then also add, for example, another step that I don't just do a fan setting, but also a power setting. I go now with the power to step 9. So do it a bit earlier. Then, of course, I have to take off this step because it would be double. And like this, I can just change any step. I can say, for example, then with 200 degrees, I don't only do a fan sitting to level 6. I also, for example, do a drum setting of 8 instead of 9. So I can just do any changes that I want. I can add a new step. So say, for example, then with the trigger at 200 IBTS 202 degrees. I put my fan on setting number 12. So I push it all the way up. Now let's say I do this procedure at 205, because this is something I sometimes like to do to pull out the chaffs from the roast drum. And then I see here end setting 206.08 degrees. What's going to happen then is an end roast alert. So the machine will tell me, please stop the roast now. And this is a recipe that I can then save. And if I want to, I can just start this recipe and then the machine will do the recipe as I have defined it. So it's preheating at 280 degrees again. And if I put in the beans, then you will see how the roaster will automatically do this recipe here. When I have recipes defined, you see them here saved in my list of recipes. You can see it's here. You will then also see when we go to Roast World that it's in my Roast World, and people can do a copy of it if they say, ah, this could be an interesting recipe by Ingo. If I don't want this, then I can mark it private so that people don't see my recipe, and like that they cannot access it and copy it. But I leave it now public. So I'm in the active roast. My machine is telling me it's ready to roast. The recipe is loaded. So I can take another 500 grams of beans. And then go over to my roaster and start the roast.
Roast start.
As you know from the other roast before, it jumped now after the charging into the roasting mode. Now, same as in the playback, I don't have to do anything. I just let the roaster do its own work. If I want to stop the recipe, I could just deactivate it here. But now I let it run and you can see already the first steps that had happened. So the change from P10 to P9, F5 to F4 here. So now we are in first crack and you can see how the machine has beautifully done this roast. It did all the changes here according to the recipe that I've entered. So when I want to do production roasts and have a set roasting profile that I want to repeat, you have seen before how precisely the machine is running. So I can then really do one roast after the other with the same recipe. And you will see then in a couple of seconds, the machine will give me the sign to end the roast. So you can see my idea here of putting the fan to F12 was actually a good one, but I did it far too early because it just took out all the energy from my system and it then just cooled down the roaster. So if you want to do this hack and it really works to take out the chaffs, then just do it a couple of seconds before you end the roast. But beside of that, you now understand how you can do roast, how you can do recipes. And now let's go over to Roast World. I hope this video was helpful for you. As said, this was a short extract from the Aillio Bullet Masterclass, which is an online course on the Aillio Bullet, where in more than 4.5 hours we talk about everything related to the Aillio Bullet, how it's working, all its functions, but we're also talking about roasting in general, and then always connected with a hands-on approach on how to do all the settings on the Aillio Bullet directly, so that after having done the masterclass, you know precisely how to get the best out of this machine. If this is of interest to you, then have a look at it. You find the link to it right here, or in the description. And if the Aillio Bullet in general is something that is of interest to you, then have a look at our website where you find all the details about it. You find it on roasttravels.com.